she goes out with other guys. Here's a moral and a story from that guy. Oh, no.
Welcome to the Freedom Festival. On behalf of Backstreet Music and Honey Radio and Magic, we are the Larados, and we're here to bring back some classic rock and roll. How about it, Tommy? What do you got to say to that?
I got to say what you say, Tony. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Then watch out.
Here we go again.
Yep, 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 yep. Work, work, work.
I wonder.
underwear.
The meeting of romance in chapter 4, you break up.
Oh, but you get just one more chance. Do I wonder, wonder whom it is?
Who wrote the book of love?
I love you, love you, darling.
Do I wanna do what you wanna do?
Speaking with Gary from the Larados. Welcome.
It's a pleasure to be down here at Hart Plaza tonight for the Freedom Festival. It's fantastic, and as we can see, the crowd is very much alive, and there's magic in the air.
Isn't it great having an international Freedom Festival here in Detroit and bringing all these people down?
Well, it is. You know, when you really come to think of it, Detroit is probably, you know, one of the greatest American cities in this country because we have a border. You know, we can cross the river, and we're in Canada, and we come on this side, and we're in Detroit. We've got people here from Canada tonight, and from Detroit, and they're all here for one reason, the revival of classic rock and roll.
A lot of your fans, they're practically going off the railing trying to catch a view of you.
Well, I'm glad that nobody fell off because it's pretty high when you know, that's a long fall, it's about 30 feet. But this place, if you've never been here before, is just absolutely fantastic. It's like a big round circle, and they have lights going around the top, and there's people hanging from the balconies and from, you know, from the amphitheater itself. It's fantastic. I mean, this place is alive with music tonight. And we've got some great groups. You know, we've got Detroit's own Contours. We've got New York's Crystals. We've got New York's Drifters. And, of course, you know, well, Detroit's Laredos. But it's been a fantastic show. And, I mean, there's really magic in the air. If you can get out there tonight, you can see people, you know, dancing. Basically, dancing in the streets is what they're doing. And It's the old days all over again. I mean, you could turn this clock back, you know, from anywhere from 1957 to maybe 1964, and it's like it's all being reborn. It's fantastic.
Is this like a revival of Detroit, bringing it back live?
Oh, it's exactly. You know, they can say what they want, but I look out in that crowd, and there's a lot of young people out there. I mean, people that weren't even born in this era of music, and they're all really digging it. And a lot of them, you know, like we'll be singing at a concert or something, and young people will come up to us and they'll say, like we'll do a tune like the Duke of Earl, and they'll say, did you guys write that number? And we'll say, no, we didn't write it. Your mom and dad remember it, you know. But they actually, it's new to them, you know. And if you can listen to the top 40 today, you'll hear all of this influx of the old rock and roll coming back. And it's all top 40, and the kids love it because they think it's new.
I think they feel that beat, that original beat that everyone puts into it.
Right. Well, what they really feel, I think, is, you know, music has been everywhere that it can be, and now it's come back to the number 12. It's right at the beginning again. And they're saying to themselves, you know, we remember the original. Well, they don't remember the words, but the words have a real meaning to them. And I think, you know, the electric, hard metal sound is really, really kind of going out, you know. And the old stuff is really coming back in. And that's basically where we're at. You know, we're right back where we started from.
Sure, people want to relate to that music and feel it.
Well, sure they do. It was a freer time, and we didn't have the problems that we have, you know, today. At least I didn't think we had as many problems back in those days. And it's been great because, you know, we've got the support of the young people and the support of the older people. And it's just been a beautiful feeling. It's all coming back. And tonight is proof of it because this place, I don't know, I'd like to have a head count on this place tonight, but there's got to be, I don't know, 7,000, 8,000, 9,000 people out there. And, I mean, they're just going nuts.
Sure, and it brings them back to Detroit to enjoy it, maybe hopefully come back for another reason, besides to see the Larados and
right.
The rest of the revival.
Right. I'll tell you, this downtown Detroit is alive. You can look around. You know, earlier tonight we seen the old double-winger planes up there, you know, with smoke behind them, and the parachutes, you know, they were, you know, jumping out. And you can look around, you can see the Hart Plaza behind you and the, you know, the Rensen and the balloons and everything and the river. I mean, you know, Detroit is alive and well. Let's face it. It's all come back.
And we're glad that the Laredos are such a good part of Detroit and that all your fans came out to witness this. And hopefully you had as much good time as they did.
Well, I'll tell you what. This is, like I say, old-time classic rock and roll. And, you know, we love Detroit and hopefully Detroit loves the Laredos.
I'm sure they do. Thanks a lot, Gary, for spending some time with us.
Thank you very much.
You don't see a morning dancing like you see the morning to come to see the beat. this ain't just talk. You better watch yourself. You better stay in line.
Fred Boogie Bryan from Honey Radio, who helped put this show together. Tell us a little bit about this show.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. We wanted to get the groups that would really reflect what rock and roll was all about back in the 50s and 60s, and I think we pulled it off with our lineup today.
And I think the crowd really appreciated it. There's one heck of a crowd out there.
To capacity. I don't think they couldn't even fit a Volkswagen load of people out there anymore. I mean, it's just everybody's having a great time. There's been no trouble. And everybody's just partying out there in Detroit, man, during the Freedom Festival. It's really good to see.
What do you think the people's feelings are about music, like say, for instance, for the four groups that you have here? You think it's coming back and it's staying with the young people?
There's no doubt about it that it's coming back. That can be reflected in contemporary music. There's been a lot of the oldies redone, actually. There's been a lot of those redone, and it's right there. It's proof positive that there's a generation of people out there that perhaps don't know what it's all about, and they're learning this for the first time. It's sort of like a new experience for them, like a new wave, you know, and they're learning that for the first time, and people are going, the ones that do know what it is are going back to it, and that's reflected by the tunes that are being redone again in the contemporary scene, the oldies.
You think this type of music could maybe bring like younger people and like the older people together because they have something to relate to?
Take a look outside.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All them people?
A lot of older people and a lot of young people out there jiving to the same stuff, yeah.
That's what it's all about. And how about reviving Detroit? Do you think this did something for it, like Detroit Live again?
Oh, yeah. Every time you bring something that brings the people together and they're all partying out there together and just having a good time, I think that's what makes any city, that's any city's heart. Yeah, the people are the blood, yeah.
These people really love these bands, and I think they're True Heart fans, and also True Heart fans of your radio station.
Well, Honey Radio being the only all-oldies radio station in the Detroit area, well, they sort of like tend to coalesce around Honey Radio as a nucleus of this whole phenomenon that's happening now. So we're riding the crest right now.
Do you like doing something in the like city, like here at the Hart Plaza? Do you feel like it's bringing more people here, and is it good for Detroit?
I think it's the greatest thing to hit Detroit, especially doing oldies things like this. We're doing a special thing. It's sort of secretive now, but we're planning something for a year from now that will be pretty massive as far as oldies are concerned. So we'll keep the people guessing about that.
And keep us informed, hopefully.
Well, we'll try.
Great. Well, Fred Boogie Bryan, thank you so much for sharing some time with us. And now we're going to go back to the show, right?
Let's go back and party hardy. Come on.
Thank you.
feeling so fine.
Thank you.
Concludes a special live coverage for Music Monitor. We'd like to thank the Larados for being our guest on our Golden Oldie series. Also, thanks to Honey and Magic Radio for putting on the concert during the International Freedom Festival at the Hart Plaza in downtown Detroit. And thank you for watching us. Till next time, good night from Music Monitor.
Strikes 12.